Hi, I'm Riley, and this is my first makeup tutorial on YouTube. So today I'll just be showing off this basic summer look, which doesn't require foundation or false lashes, which is something that I know I personally and other people don't like having to deal with in the summer, especially when the freckles are out and your skin's just feeling really good and fresh and clean. So just keep watching and let me know what you think.
To begin with, I will start with my Anastasia Beverly Hills Dip Brow in Auburn and the E17 brush. I will pull that along the bottom of my eyebrow and blend. Then I will take it and I will outline the top of my brow and just make sure it all connects at the bottom and just begin to blend it all in so it's a nice and smooth gradient. To make sure the brows aren't too boxy, I always blend up at the beginning of the brow and I don't line on the top too close to the middle. Another cool thing about the pomade is that it won't cake or flake no matter how much you build up on it, so if you want darker eyebrows to match your hair, then you can just add more and it won't get gross. I use the darker auburn at the tail of my brow so that it has an ombre look. Brushing the brows acts as a blender and helps the product settle in further. For a highlighter and sculptor, I use a Wet n Wild eyeliner in white. It's only 99 cents and it works really great. I use it to outline my entire brow everywhere, and it looks really funny right now, but it will look better once it's blended. Then I take a tiny little concealer brush and I just blend it everywhere as if it was concealer. Now I will go in with my Anastasia Clear Brow Gel and set my eyebrows in place. The gel will keep the product in place and make sure my eyebrows stay in the same shape I want them to. First, I start with Raw Sienna and Burnt Orange as a blending color and put it all over my lid. Then I use Burnt Orange to darken it up. After, I use Reglar on the outer crease. I use Cypress Umber on the outer V to give it a dark, smoky appearance. I finished the eyeshadow with putting Vermeer all over my lid. I go in with my black Sephora liner and I begin to make a triangle that will become the wing. If you do mess up, there's nothing wrong with making a bigger wing to cover your mistakes. After I've made the wing, I begin to make a nice smooth line across the bottom of my lid. I'm going to go all over this with a black pencil liner so that it darkens up and I can get really close to the lash line without irritating my eyes. Here I'll be taking a flat brush with the color burnt orange on it and I will rub it all over my lower lash line. I used Lash Gaza Mascara by Too Faced and I put it all over my eyelashes in a windshield wiper motion. I'll be priming my face with Prime Time by Bare Minerals, and although it's not for foundation, it's going to be for everything else that goes on my face, including the blush, bronzer, and highlight. Even though I squirted nearly half the bottle on my face, this still has a really nice matte finish and it hydrates your skin all day. Urban Decay's All Nighter will also help set the eyeshadow and eyeliner. Now I'll take my Minerals bronzer and I will put it all over the contour of my cheek. The bronzer isn't used to contour my face, but rather to create a nice warm summer glow. I make sure not to put the bronzer too low or too high, or else it'll create a big, shiny mess. Next, from my Ulta Radiance palette, I'll be using the blush just to put it all over my cheeks. And I don't smile while doing this just because it puts it in the wrong spot. So you want to place the product right over the bronzer, kind of up and around there. I use this dark Bare Minerals powder to make my forehead look less big. I take a big fluffy powder brush, that's also Bare Minerals, I dip it in the product, and I begin to buff it all over the top of my forehead. For my highlight, I'll be using Laura Geller's Big Squirrel in Gilded Honey, and I'll just use a small little blush brush to get some product on there and put it along the cheekbone of my face. I'm only putting a little bit of highlight on this look to keep it nice, clean, and simple. Then I'll apply a little bit of highlighter on the button of my nose. I add more highlighter to the button of my nose and put some in the tear ducts of my eyes to make sure that they really pop. And after that, I'll add some to my Cupid's bow to make my lips look a little bit more full. To line my lips, I'll be using a lipstick crayon, which is Bite Beauty's Color Glance. So here's the finished look. Thank you guys so much for watching. Give me a thumbs up and subscribe.